CES was another super busy show for AMD since they announced a ton of new products at the show floor. If you haven't checked out our video showing off their 2018 roadmap, make sure you do that right away. You might be wondering why this video is coming after our CES coverage, and that's because we wanted to look over AMD's offerings at the show and then combine them into a single video, the detailed Raven Ridge, Ryzen 2, X470, and more. This video will be going over some of the more exciting things in a bit more detail. Those things will actually be coming up really soon. This includes the new generation Ryzen desktop processors and the Raven Ridge APUs that will combine first generation Ryzen processing cores along with Vega graphics. We found a few examples of those at the show floor at CES, so let's look at it a bit closer.
Wondering how to fix a boring fan? Check out Halo's RGB. They are super slim fan frames that light up your blades of any shade, come in 120 and 140mm sizes to fit any fan, and are controlled through your motherboard or your Fantex case. Available in beautiful aluminum or simple plastic, it's time to Halo's your build. Outline what matters.
So there's a lot to get through in this video, and the first thing has to be the upcoming second generation Ryzen processors that use a new 12nm manufacturing process. By moving towards 12nm, AMD has been able to achieve significantly higher clock speeds without more power consumption or heat production. That's super important, since in order for Ryzen to compete against Coffee Lake, particularly in gaming, higher frequencies in lightly threaded situations were needed. There will also be some improvements in areas like cache and memory speed and latency. Hopefully we'll see Ryzen finally be able to consistently hit DDR4 memory speeds above 3000 MHz, because we weren't able to achieve that before without overclocking and more voltage. Speaking of gaming, there will be a new multi-core algorithm boost state for higher performance in gaming and other real-world scenarios. There won't be any significant architecture changes to Zen Plus and the second generation Ryzen processors, but in order to take better advantage of the lower power consumption and potential for higher frequencies, AMD will be updating Precision Boost and the extended frequency range technologies. While we don't have all that much information about how these two items will be changing, it looks like Precision Boost will be able to predict upcoming workloads and further balance core output. That means higher base and boost frequencies can be achieved more often. Something else that is important to take note of is with Ryzen 2, there will be new motherboards. But before you panic, don't worry, they won't absolutely be needed for the new CPUs. You see, AMD has committed to keep the AM4 socket around for a while, until at least 2019. Current motherboard chipsets like B350 and X370 will be compatible with upcoming Raven Ridge APUs and second generation Ryzen desktop processors. That's good news. The bad news is that even though older motherboards will have some forward compatibility, you may be missing out on key next generation features and performance if you pair up an old motherboard with a new CPU. The proof of this is apparent with the upcoming X470 motherboard series. While a simple BIOS update will ensure second generation Ryzen CPUs are simply drop-in upgrades for X370, only newer boards will be truly optimized for them. AMD wasn't willing to talk about any details, but it looks like X470 will feature improved performance, additional overclocking capabilities, and some new feature level support. We did see this at Gigabyte's so-called X470 motherboard, and other channels have covered it as well, but what we heard was a bit different. This was actually designed as an X370 based product called the Aorus X370 Gaming 7 Wi-Fi, but they decided to change their flagship boards to X470. Basically, that means X470 likely won't bring much to the table from a chipset level. Most of the performance Ryzen 2 will offer will likely be from the processor itself rather than the motherboard. That means you'll likely be totally okay staying with X370 rather than paying a premium for X470. This brings me to the next part of AMD's big announcements, the Raven Ridge APUs, which will be launching on February the 12th. The first of those will be the Ryzen 5 2400G that comes with 4 cores, 8 threads, with a base clock of 3.6 GHz and a boost clock of 3.9 GHz. The Vega graphics side of that chip will have 11 compute units, which means 704 SIMD units, or roughly 1/5 the raw processing power of Vega 56. It may not sound like much, but this is crazy powerful for an integrated graphics chip, and for $170, there seems to be a lot of value here. The Ryzen 3 2200G is cut down a bit with lower boost and base frequencies, but it's still natively a quad-core part, and its graphics side has 8 compute units enabled. At just $100, I could see this becoming the go-to solution for entry-level systems, and both of these are 65-watt TDP parts. We actually saw a bunch of notebooks with these APUs, and they all look amazing with low profiles and great battery life. I can't wait to get my hands on some of these. One thing you need to know is that even though both of these carry the Ryzen 2000 series branding, they don't use the new 12-nanometer Zen Plus cores that will be found in second-generation Ryzen CPUs, since both will be living in AMD's lineup at the same time. I'm thinking buyer confusion is certainly possible, so make sure you link anyone back to this video for an explanation. So you can actually see here that through higher clock speeds, the 2400G and 2200G are able to easily outperform the 1400 and 1200 in every single application. Now I know that like with Intel processors, you're buying an integrated GPU and won't need if you use a discrete one, but it's hard to argue against these numbers given how low the new APUs are priced. This makes it even more apparent, at least in multi-thread environments, the 2400G and 2200G are not only better than the original Ryzen CPUs they're replacing, but they can also handily beat Intel CPUs from a price-to-performance standpoint. Now, the 2400G is going to have a tough fight against the i3-8100, particularly in gaming with a discrete graphics card, but it still looks like a phenomenal value. AMD even tested the Ryzen 5 2400G against Intel's i5-8400, and it looks like integrated performance will line up with that Intel CPU when it's paired with a discrete GT1030 GPU. What's even more impressive is that Intel/AMD setup will have a TDP that's about 30 watts higher than the integrated AMD solution. Obviously, AMD is going to show scenarios where the multi-core architecture is going to shine, and these are two more instances, particularly because the integrated graphics are being used in both. Nonetheless, there's definitely something to take away from this. The new APUs are even better able to compete with the original Ryzen CPUs at their given price points. In gaming, the 2400G is obviously going to be the better bet, given how far Intel's integrated GPUs are behind from an architecture and driver perspective. This is likely why Intel decided to team up with the Radeon Technology Group for some semi-custom chips that will provide high-end gaming capabilities to thin and light notebooks. The 2200G is in the same position as well against the i3-8100, but it will definitely be interesting to see how these chips line up with one another in real-world scenarios. Like with all other chips in AMD's current lineup, these new APUs will feature fully unlocked CPU multipliers as well as capability to overclock the Vega graphics subsystem. AMD actually showed us that a simple bump in memory speeds will result in a pretty significant gaming performance speedup. Adding some GPU overclocking on top of that saw over 40% better performance in 3D Mark Firestrike. If that isn't impressive, I don't know what is. So guys, that pretty much closes out our quick rundown of some interesting stuff AMD has coming up in the first half of this year. What do you guys think about it? Will you be waiting for Ryzen 2 or will you jump to take advantage of those lower first generation Ryzen prices? And what about those Raven Ridge APUs? Would you be willing to give AMD a shot on that front? Let us know in the comments down below. I'm Ebo with Hardware Canucks. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.